هم الشيطان أعمالهم فصدهم عن السبيل فهم لا يهتدون ألا يسجدوا لله الذي يخرج الخبأ في السماوات والأرض ويعلم ما تخفون وما تعلنون. When we talk about عدل, about justice, we have to get the lesson from this surah. Sulaiman, he discovered that the Hudhud was absent. Yes, but he did not punish him until he verified that he's guilty or not guilty. And he did not put him in the jail with no valid evidences. So he told even him, still using him, still let him work, still let him free. قال اذهب كتابي هذا. You are the one. You will help us to verify if you are guilty or not. You're still free until we have sure evidences that you are guilty. ارجع إليه اذهب بكتابي هذا فألقه إليهم ثم تول عنهم فانظر ماذا يرجعون. Go with my book and drop it there to Bilqis. Then see what they will return. What will happen? ارجع إليهم فلنأتينهم بجنود لا قبل له. اذهب بكتابي هذا فألقه إليهم ثم تول عنهم فانظر ماذا يرجعون. Then she received the letter as we talked yesterday. She said she called the people, all the ministers and so. إني ألقي إلي كتاب كريم. الملأ in the Quran. قالت يا أيها الملأ. الملأ is not the general people. No. The leaders of the people. The leaders of people. The leaders of the tribe. إني ألقي إلي كتاب كريم. إنه من سليمان وإنه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سليمان he wrote the book and titled the book with بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Started, recommended when you do anything, say بسم الله. بسم الله. In the time of food, بسم الله. In the time of entering the masjid, بسم الله. Out of the masjid, بسم الله. Riding your car, بسم الله. Going out from your house, بسم الله توكلت على الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألا تعلوا علي وأتوني مسلمين. Then when she read that, she got affected by this strong words. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألا تعلوا علي وأتوني مسلمين. Then I am inviting you to come to me, to follow me, to be a Muslim before it is late. ألا تعلوا علي. Don't be arrogant. Don't let the arrogance keep you away from the right path. ألا تعلوا علي وأتوني مسلمين. Then she consulted the people. أفتوني في أمري. Help me to make the decision. She's consulting with especially the people in charge. قالت يا أيها الملأ أفتوني في أمري ما كنت قاطعة أمرا حتى تشهدون. Help me to make the right decision. The dictators of today, they do not consult any. They expected themselves they are the best. And some of them, they reach it to the level that they are even better to understand this life better than the prophets. But this lady, she was good. قالت She said, this queen, she said, you have to share with me the responsibility. Consult. إني ألقي إلي كتاب كريم. She is very wise. She said, والله I received respectful letter. كتاب كريم. إنه من سليمان. It's from Prophet Sulaiman. وإنه بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Started by this. Unique words. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألا تعلوا علي إنه من سليمان. Then she said, help me. They said, we are your soldiers. Just guide us. The scholar, they said, she has 12,000 soldiers and many followers. thousands and thousands of followers also. They will follow them if they decide to fight. نحن أولو قوة وأولو بأس شديد والأمر إليك فانظري ماذا تأمرين. She is wise. She is حكيمة. قالت يا أيها الملأ. قالت إن الملوك إذا دخلوا قرية أفسدوها وجعلوا أعزة أهلها أذلة وكذلك يفعلون. It's not good. It's not good to establish fighting. There was no need for that. Because usually if either Suleiman is a king or good man, good leader or bad leader, if he's dictator, he will cause a big harm. Because always the dictator kings, they cause big harm everywhere. Corruption everywhere.
Sheikh Hamdi, did you want, am I on the right ayah just to make sure?
What again?
أنا على الآية صح؟
الآن الآية 36.
Okay, خلاص. Because some people are asking to go up. Okay. جزاك الله خير. Sorry.
إن شاء الله. يلا. If you want to display the Quran, it's good. We'll do it. So then she planned to send a gift, bribe, to Suleiman. She decided to send a bribe to Suleiman. قالت إن الملوك إذا دخلوا قرية أفسدوها وجعلوا أعزة أهلها أذلة وكذلك يفعلون. The bad kings, if they enter the inner city, they will do corruption. So what is the best to do? The best? Yes. Let me go through the politics. What is the first step of politics? Bribe. غشوة. Let me give him rishwa. If he accepted the bribe, be easy to deal with him. وَإِنِّي مُرْسِلَةٌ إِلَيْهِمْ بِهَدِيَّةٌ. And the scholars, they said, she collected very high quality and valuable stuff, gold, silver, many things. It's amazing. And she collected that and sent it as gift to his caravan to go to Suleiman. To give this gift from Bilqis. إنه من سليمان. Sorry. وإني مرسلة إليهم بهدية فناظرة بما يرجع المرسلون. Yes, stop here. Verse 36. Now on the screen. Then the one or the group of people, they went to Suleiman with great gifts, loads. But Suleiman, even he did not look to it. And they expected, they are coming with money. قَالَ فَلَمَّا جَاءَ سُلَيْمَانَ قَالَ. When this caravan came to Suleiman, قَالَ. Suleiman replied, what is this? He said, that's our queen. Our queen, Bilqis, she sent some gifts for you. He did not even look to the gifts. What is the gifts is? أَتُمِدُّونَنِي بِمَال. You are gaining me by giving me bribe. أَتُمِدُّونَنِي بِمَال. فَمَا آتَانِيَ اللَّهُ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا آتَاكُمْ. What Allah gave me is better than what you have. بَلْ أَنْتُمْ. Some people like you, they will be happy with bribe, with gifts. But I am not. I have one goal. What is the goal? Guide you to worship Allah. That's my goal. That's my goal. Then he told them, take your gift back. Go to your queen. ارجع إليهم فلنأتينهم بجنود لا قبل لهم بها ولنخرجنهم منها أذلة وهم صاغرون. Go back. We are not behind the money. We are behind the hidayah, the guidance. We are asking them to come to the truth. They have power, yes, but they misguided. That's what I need. I don't need their wealth. I don't need anything from them. I need them to know Allah. That's my message. My message, go to them and tell them, tell your queen, tell your people behind you. What I need, that I am asking you to come to be a Muslim. Then if they decide to fight me, they cannot fight me. They cannot. Because they have soldiers, you never expected these soldiers. You never. There is jinn, there is birds, there is animals, there is a lot. There is ants, also human. So it means we have many types of soldiers. And indeed, we'll let them go from this beautiful land in Yemen. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala give the Yemen now the freedom and give the people freedom and give them ability to worship Allah. Those people, they have great hearts. They have hikmah, as Prophet Muhammad says. Then the man, he came back to them. When he told the queen Bilqis what Sulaiman said, said yes, Allah, I don't have option now. I have to go to Sulaiman. Everyone, all us, they say, the scholar, they said she collected 12,000 soldiers with her, and she came to her throne, her arsh, and she started to, because it is, her arsh was amazing, from gold and the silver decoration, from the high quality stuff, diamond and so. Then she prepared, she put this in number of rooms, and she put a lot of flux, and she told someone, that's my stuff, no one. You have to guard all my palace and my throne, and no one should reach this area. And they lock it and secured, and no one even come and step in my place. And she secured everything. Then she said, I have to go to Sulaiman. I have to go, and became a Muslim with him. So she decided. She gathered the people, 12,000 with her, and she started moving from Yemen day after day, going to Palestine. That's what takes more than a month. And Sulaiman alayhi salam, by his camera of jinn, the jinn watching what is going on. Oh, Sulaiman, they are in the way. She prepared everything. She is coming with her soldiers to come to follow you in the way now. That's 10 days far, 5 days far, 2 days far, or 1 day far away from you. They are now very close. Then Sulaiman now, he wants to show the guards there guarding her stuff there now for more than a month. Now everything is there. Then Sulaiman now started to make something surprise, miracle, to help her to be a Muslimah. Because the people need something to guide them, especially those in the position of power. They need something amazing. Wallahi, I don't know what is the people in the position of power now in the world. Why they do not now come in the TV and say, Wallahi, nashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa nashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Why? Subhanallah, this virus now shows people. Subhanallah, I read yesterday in Al Jazeera that the COVID-19 reached Al Kremlin in Russia, reached Congress in America. So imagine, yes, why? Because the arrogance. But this one, this lady, she was not arrogant. If she's arrogant, she will never consult with her people. She's arrogant, will never discuss and try. She's arrogant, she will be like Fir'aun. She will be like the arrogance of today. But then Sulaiman, one day, the caravan of Bilqis just closed to Palestine. Then Sulaiman now, he called the people. He called them. أيكم يأتيني بعرشها قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين أيكم يأتيني بعرشها قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين. Who can come? They are now maybe few hours far away from my place now to arrive. Who can bring the all the stuff of Bilqis, her arsh, her throne? Who can bring it here from Yemen to Palestine? أيكم يأتيني بعرشها قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين؟ The jinn, they are working under the care of Suleiman. قال عفريت من الجن. One of the jinn, عفريت. He said, me. I am strong. I can bring it before finishing your lecture. Suleiman, he used to sit down from the morning till noon to solve the problem, to do judgment between people. He said, before finishing, by Dhuhr, everything will be here. He said, no, it is late. I need sooner. وَإِنِّي عَلَيْهِ لَقَوِيٌّ أَمِينٌ. Then, قال الذي عنده علم من الكتاب أنا آتيك به قبل أن يرتد إليك طرفك. So, the scholar they said, someone he has علم من الكتاب. Some scholars even they said that's Suleiman himself, but some also said that's one of the friends of Suleiman, his name Asif. Asif ibn Barkhia. Asif ibn Barkhia. كان صديقا. صديقا يعلم اسم الله الأعظم. He knows what is the greatest name of Allah تبارك وتعالى. He told Suleiman, Suleiman, just look. Look far away, as far you can look. Then come back. When you do that, you will find the throne of Bilqis here. How? He said, قال ابن كثير, قال فقام فتوضأ. قام فتوضأ. ثم دعا الله. فقال يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. That's it. The دعاء. So some scholars they said, That can be اسم الله الأعظم. يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. Oh Allah. Oh Allah. يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. Means, يا رب حقق ما طلبه سليمان. يا رب bring the throne of Bilqis here. Then immediately in a less than minute, the arsh is there. Then Suleiman, he says, they are very short time to arrive. قال نكروا لها عرشها. Change, do some change in the arsh. The right, put it in the left in the right. The yellow, put it in the place of the red in the place of the green. Do some change in the arsh. Then, نكروا لها عرشها ننظر أتهتدي أم تكون من الذين لا يهتدون. نكروا لها عرشها ننظر. Change little bit in her throne to know if she is wise enough to recognize that's her عرش or not. ننظر أتهتدي أم تكون من الذين لا يهتدون. If she is smart, quiet, relax, able to accept the truth, or she is rush, disturbed. Then, فلما جاءت, just as they done that, then she arrived. فلما جاءت, قيل, she looked, what is this? It looks like my throne. قيل أهكذا عرشك. That's your throne. I close it. I put locks. I left guards guarding my عرش. So how this came here? It looks like. See. The answer. Very smart answer. Very smart answer. قالت كأنه هو. Looks like exactly. She did not deny it's impossible, and also she did not say yes 100%. Because how my throne come from Yemen? But it is also the same. قالت كأنه هو. She's the answer showing us her personality. Her personality. Some people crazy. Some people fool. That's like someone, he was talking with his wife. And then he said, somebody, he told him, do you know, if you talk to your wife at night, the moon is full, let her look to the moon and look, tell her, can you see the moon? Yes. Nice, beautiful. Yes, you are even more beautiful than the moon. Someone, he told him, that's good. Then, and he take her outside and he said, okay, that's, and he want to make a romantic night. And he told her, can you see the moon? She said, do you expect that I am blind? Allah, done. They cannot go forward. They cannot go again to say anything good. Allah, she closed the door. Some people, they are aghbiya. Some people, they are fool. They do not even know how to speak. They do not know how to deal with people. They stuck with everyone. Why? So see the answer. كأنه هو السلام. السلام على العظم. وأوتينا العلم من قبلها وكنا مسلمين. Yes, she has علم. But سليمان has more علم. She has علم. But سليمان has more. وصدها. But why she has علم? But she has been misguided. Why? وصد. The reason? The environment. The environment. Maybe some people, they are good. They have good mind. They are mindful. They are smart. They are so, but they are living with bad community. They will be affected by that. You are home now. Why? Because you are scared to involve with some infected people. You will be infected with COVID-19. So what COVID-19? That's one of the sickness. But there is some more sickness. Akhlaq, sickness of characters, sickness of so many. So why she was misguided? She was kafira. She was not believer. Why? She's smart and so. She has good fitrah. She has good nature. Because of the community. Because of the environment. Bad environment. إنها كانت من قوم كافرين. قيل لها. Then Sulaiman, now he wants to show here that the Muslimin also can be powerful. Also, but the Muslimin, they should not be always under the feet of others. No. But here Sulaiman, prophet, but he's not the slave of the desires. He's not the slave of dunya. He's the slave of Allah. We have balance. قيل لها دخل الصرح. Some scholars they said قيل. Who said قيل لها? She have been told, enter the palace now to meet with Sulaiman. Enter the palace. Who told her? He said, the scholars, they said, she used to be called by someone she doesn't see. That's jinn. Jinn say, go. We are serving here. Who is calling me? قيل لها دخل الصرح. Sulaiman, he has a big palace over the sea. Over the sea, over the water. قيل لها دخل الصرح. Enter the palace. How? But the palace there on the water, how can I reach to the entrance of the palace? Go! Go what? There's water here. No. She hold her clothes. She hold her clothes. Not to be wet. To walk in the water to go to the palace. But subhanAllah, when she stepped, oh, that's not water. The water under the glass. There is glass. That's a qawarir. قال إنه صرح ممرد من قوارير. The road to the palace from glass. The palace itself glass. And subhanAllah, not glass, that's qawarir, the best quality. قال إنه قيل لها ادخل الصرح فلما رأته حسبته لجة وكشفت عن ساقيها قال إنه صرح ممرد من قوارير. I expected my throne, that's the best. My throne compared to this, nothing. And when she came to Sulaiman, قالت رب إني ظلمت نفسي. والله that's a sign that she has humbleness. قالت رب إني ظلمت نفسي. Many people misguided, but they did not say this word. Many people, they are sinners, but they did not say this word. They did not admit that they oppress themselves. ظلم النفس, ظلم الإنسان لنفسه بمعصية ربه. قالت إني ظلمت نفسي, أي فيما مضى. I oppressed myself long, long time to be away from the guidance. But now, إن شاء الله بإذن الله, I'll go in the right direction. وأسلمت. Oh Allah, I declare شهادة now. وأسلمت مع سليمان لله رب العالمين. سبحان الله. سبحان الله. Then she accepted Islam. She accepted Islam with سليمان. She became a Muslim. She said, my Lord, indeed I have wronged myself and I submit with سليمان to Allah, Lord of world, رب العالمين. Brothers and sisters, just yesterday I was not able to finish the story, but alhamdulillah, see how the Quran showing us that is the Iman, the Islam is the biggest ni'mah, in our life. Wallahi, if you are rich, you will never be rich like Bilqis. You will never be powerful like Bilqis. But subhanAllah, she is missing something. Based on the fitrah, based on our nature, we missed. What we missed? Something. If you have it, everything will be easy after that. What? Iman. Faith. Iman. If you have Iman, everything will be easy. So, and also, you can see also the second point, the lesson, that's very important. Very important for the Muslim to be also powerful. Powerful in Iman. Powerful in Akhlaq. Powerful in everything. Even body, physically, be power. Also financially, be powerful. Work, gain money and give and help. Don't be the one asking the people to give you sadaqah, but be the one giving sadaqah. Don't be the weak one. No. The hadith. This hadith. Remember this hadith. Very important hadith. قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, المؤمن القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف, وفي كل خير. احرص على ما ينفعك, استعن بالله ولا تعجز, ولا تقل لو أني فعلت كذا لكان كذا, فإن لو تفتح عمل الشيطان. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, the strong believer is better and beloved to Allah than the weak one. Even both of them believers, yes, but he's more beloved to Allah and better than the weak one. He can serve the deen of Allah. See Sulaiman. Sulaiman now is weak. How he can grab Bilqis and her people and the Yemen area to Islam? Wallahi, he can't. He did not fight. He did not kill. But show them the power. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the seventh year of Hijrah, 1 year after the treaty of Al-Hudaybiyah, he went back to do Umrah as the agreement was. And when he went there, which is still sunnah now, still sunnah for all of us now, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he uncovered his right muscle, his right adalat. That's the sunnah now when you put the ihram, uncover the right shoulder. The right shoulder, keep it uncovered. That's the sunnah. And then Prophet Muhammad, he did that. The Sahaba, they do that. The name of that in Ihram, Al-Ittiba'. Al-Ittiba'. And he did that. Then he said, he told the Sahaba, they are doing Umrah al-Qada in the seventh year. Because Mecca, empty now. And the people of Mecca, they are watching from the top of the mountains. What the Muslims do in Umrah? Because Umrah, it was not known before Islam. Hajj was known. Umrah, no. They want to see what Prophet Muhammad Sallam and his people doing as Umrah. Then Prophet Muhammad Sallam, he told the Sahaba, uncover your right shoulder and keep your muscles, because the media of Quraysh now saying that we are sick in Al-Madinah. We are very sick, we are very weak, we are the sickness spread everywhere. So show them we are not like that. قال رحم الله امرأ أراهم اليوم منه قوة. May Allah be merciful with the one showing the enemy of Allah his power. His power. You are strong. We are strong. We are not sick. Yes. مؤمن القوي. But first of all, قوي في الإيمان. Strong in his faith. Number two, قوي في العلم. قوي في العلم. Learn. Go. Study. Be on the top of ilm. And also قوي في الجسم. Be strong in your body. Avoid any haram cause harmful to your body. Don't smoke. Don't drink. Don't do this. That will cause harm. Will cause harm for your body. Eat healthy. Don't eat junk food. Eat healthy food. Yes. Be the one. Be the strong one. Oh, and also be strong financially. Try to find a good job. So instead of seeking help, giving, helping. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mecca, in the early time of prophethood, he was walking in the streets of Mecca. A man, he met with him. Met with him. And his name Rukana. Rukana ibn Abdi Yazid. Then this Rukana, he was a wrestler, like very strong body man. And then he saw Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, are you Muhammad? Yes. Are you the one who claimed that he's a prophet? Yes. He said, I am Rukana. Welcome, Rukana. What do you need? Welcome. He said, I am Rukana. I am the hero here in Mecca. No one can even do wrestling with me. I'll always the winner. But if you can come, come now. If you are, if you became the winner, yes, I'll admit that you are prophet. But if I am the winner, you should keep quiet. Don't talk about prophethood again. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if he told him, please let us go to Camp David, Geneva, to solve the problem peacefully. This man will be okay? No, he will humiliate Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, okay, come, let us now see who is stronger. Oh, are you ready? Yes, I'm ready. Come. Then Prophet Muhammad sallam, he hold him and he raised him and put him down. Never happened before to Rukana. Rukana said, Muhammad, you sudden me. You came all of a sudden and I was not warming up yet. He go ahead, warm up and come. Warming up, then Prophet sallam, second time, third time. Then he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أنك رسول الله. And he became one of the companions of Prophet Muhammad sallam. And the Prophet sallam, he gave him share from the battle of Tabuk. So Rukana ibn Abd Yazid. So it means Sulaiman alayhi salam, he has power, but he used this power in the right way. Some people, they need power. Yes, to do what? To oppress others? No, that's not power. That will be against you in the day of judgment. So that's one of the lessons we learn here. And also importance of the political relationship. The countries, they have to do that. They have to respect. Yes, they have to deal. Why Sulaiman alayhi salam? And also we should give security for the messengers until they deliver their message. When the one came with the bribe and the money and the sword to Sulaiman, Sulaiman did not kill him, did not attack him. It is the opposite. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent a letter to Kisra. Then Kisra, he killed the messenger of Allah. And he destroyed the book of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. See, what is the difference between the behavior of good leader and the bad leader? Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he heard that Kisra, he he killed his messenger and he destroyed his book, then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, مزق الله ملكه. May Allah destroy Kisra. And subhanAllah, Kisra destroyed by his son. In the same month, by his son. His son did inqilab, did coup against his father, and he killed his father, and he occupied the position of power. See, imagine. ولذلك, يعني, big difference between the good leader and the bad good leader, dealing with people. Dealing with people not to get their money, but dealing with people to guide them to Allah. To guide them to Allah. So Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala shows us many story, many lessons in this story. Many lessons in the story of Surah of Sulaiman with Bilqis. And Allah shows us also that every single creation, they have a sign that Allah is the creator. They have also their own life. Even the insects, even the ants, small ants, namla. Not only that, but Allah named the whole surah. Allah named the whole surah. That's it. Why this surah not Surah Al-Hudhud? This surah not Surah Al-Hudhud. Not Surah Sulaiman. Not Surah Bilqis. Not Surah Al-Yaman. The Surah Al-Naml. Al-Naml. Surah Al-Naml. Subhanallah. Yes. Don't minimize any creation. Every single creation. If you look, you will get lessons from those creation. Allah, when we look to the birds flying, yes. Oh Allah. Allah, we need as ummah to be coordinated like that. We need as ummah to have leader and follow the leader with no interruption, with no confusion, and organized like that. Organized. Imagine when we have the salah in the masjid, may Allah open the masjid soon, inshallah, and the imam saying, Allahu Akbar, and the people, the men lining behind, and the sisters lining in their place, and the kids, and so, wallah, how, it is amazing. Yes, even An-Naml, very organized, An-Nahl, the bees, very organized, even the animals, even there is rules. Wallahi, I was watching a video, subhanAllah, that one of the tigers hold a deer, and when decide to kill her, he found that she is pregnant. She is pregnant. The deer pregnant. And when he felt the movement of the baby inside, he left her. Left her. Tiger. Namir.
Allah.
Namir. لذلك, we do not minimize any naml, ant, insects, birds, animals, everything. That's it. وإم الله تبارك وتعالى says in سورة الأعراف الله تبارك وتعالى says, I want to get this verse because it is
كيف الآية؟ أنا فتح السورة.
أنت فتح السورة, هقول لك على الآية الآن. Verse in Surah Al-An'am and another one in Surah Al-A'raf. In Surah Al-An'am, Allah says, وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا إِلَّا هُوَ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين وهو الذي يتوفاكم بالليل ويعلم ما جرحتم بالنهار ثم يبعثكم فيه ليقضى أجل مسمى ثم إليه مرجعكم ثم ينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون والله amazing. But the verse in Surah Al-A'raf also, inshallah, may Allah help me to find it easy because not my mushaf with me, that's the tafsir. So inshallah I'll find this verse to end my talk with this verse inshallah. Iznillah azza wa jal.
تعرف الآية بتبلش في إيش؟
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان. إلا أمم أمثالكم ما فرطنا في الكتاب من شيء ثم إلى ربكم تحشرون. والذين كفروا وكذبوا بآياتنا أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون. So معلش بقى ما عرفناش نوصل لها دلوقتي. إن شاء الله. سبحان الله. يا رب يا رب سترك وعفوك ورضاك. يمكن ان شاء الله ان شاء الله اجيبها لكم بكره ان شاء الله. الله تبارك وتعالى mentioned in the meaning in this verse that الله تبارك وتعالى every single creation, every tribe, every kind of creation, they are umam. Umam, they are nations. They are nations. They are nations by Allah تبارك وتعالى. Don't waste your time. Inshallah. Inshallah, it is easy. Inshallah, to find it. Inshallah, بإذن الله. But I just like to hold the people until I find it. Inshallah. Maybe when they ask question. Inshallah, تبارك وتعالى. الله الأول. Inshallah, Allah will remind me. Inshallah, بإذن الله. Inshallah. But all the creations around us are أمم أمثالكم ما فرطنا في الكتاب من شيء ثم إلى ربهم يحشرون. That's what Allah تبارك وتعالى says about all the creation. They are أمم like us. So even the ants, yes, yes. إن الله. And what it means? Allah taking care of us, taking care of also the very small. You think now COVID-19 going everywhere in more than 200 countries by himself? By himself? No. Controlled by Allah. Yesterday I received a message from a pastor in the church here in Hawthorne. She said, please, please, we recommend for all people, they have religion, communities, and so, Christian, Jew, Muslim, everyone, to fast and pray and supplicate to God to remove this calamity. I answered here yesterday. I said, Alhamdulillah, for full months, not one day. She said, if tomorrow can do that. I said, wallah, it is Alhamdulillah, 1 month, it's not one day. It's not 1 week. Alhamdulillah, we have fasting. We have prayer. We have extra prayer. We have dua every day. And she said, I am happy to hear that. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Imagine the ni'mah Allah blessed us with. So it means, and also all the creation doing tasbih like us. Jazakumullah khair. Taqabbalallah minna wa minkum. You have question, and more than welcome to ask your question, inshallah.
Some questions. We have a question from Malika, inshallah. Or Malika, sorry. Go ahead.
No problem. Malika is the same thing. Jazakumullah khair. I have actually my daughter, she has a question. She asked me earlier, so she's going to say it.
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
What's your name?
Nadia.
Nadia, go ahead, Nadia, ask. We are happy to have you today with us.
Okay, go ahead.
So my question is, would everybody be good if Shaitan did not exist? I don't know. I forgot what I
If everyone is good, Shaitan does not exist?
Yeah.
Oh. What is the question now?
That's the question.
Okay. Yes. Everybody will be very good in the Jannah. The people of Jannah, all of them, they are good. So there is no Shaitan with them there. But in this dunya, huh? That's the test. You are in which grade now?
Third
grade?
Mm-hmm.
That's good. All the kids in the class, they are in the same level of education, or some of them better and some of them not good?
Mm-hmm.
Answer me, Nadia.
Mm-hmm.
All of them the same?
No.
No. Some of them excellent, some of them A plus, some of them F, some of them C, some of them B, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the dunya, that's the life here. Here in the dunya, don't expect everyone. When you go outside, you expect every lady outside like your mother?
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not everyone,
no.
Every lady like your mother. Some of them, they can cause harm for you, right?
Mm-hmm.
Some of them, they are good. So mm-hmm. That's the life here. So it means this is the nature of the life here. Before the hereafter, before the test. Do you know, in third and the fourth grade and the high school after and when you go to college, you must have test to pass. You must have test, right? And our test mm-hmm. here, that's the shaitan. Whispering to Nadia, Nadia, disobey your mother. Shaitan working. Okay. Your mother telling Nadia, please wash your plate after food. Then you ignore my mother. Who whispered to you to ignore your mother? That's the Shaitan. Shaitan, he dislikes us to live peacefully. So, but Allah, as He created us, Allah also created a Shaitan. Allah created al-jinn, al-shaytan from al-jinn. Allah also makes the people in the day of judgment, they will be under categories, like the students in the classroom. Some of them A, some of them F. And we ask Allah to be A or B, or the minimum C. By the rahmah of Allah, those people, inshallah, will enter Jannah. But we dislike to be F. Because F, that's a fire. If fire, so we ask Allah to guide all of us. Good question. Good question, Nadia.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect her, inshallah.
Allah
yahfazk. Go ahead.
Okay. So, inshallah, we have Sister Maha Saleh also.
Tawakkal ya Allah.
Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Assalamu wa rahmatullahi.
As you know, in the Dhuhr Brayar, the Salah is secretly. But for me, every time I like to read loud out in my Brayar. Is this okay?
How much loud?
It's just 5 months. I mean, it's in the room, but yeah, I like to hear myself.
Yes, you have to hear yourself.
Okay, my daughters or others outside the room.
Even if someone outside the room, but they are maharim for you.
Okay,
with
yeah.
Your husband, your father, your son, that's okay. No problem.
Okay.
So it means no problem. So that's it. It is recommended for us to read and hear ourselves. Because you yeah. cannot read without moving your lips, it's not valid. So you have to. So that's no problem, inshallah. And your salah is valid. And even Abu Huraira, he talk about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he sometimes,
mm-hmm.
in the sirri salah, dhuhr or asr, he used to read, even he said, even us behind him, we can hear, barely we can hear even his recitation also.
Mm-hmm.
So it is okay.
Okay.
Stranger people, some people they are not maharim, don't read loudly in front of them. That's it. But your salah is valid, no problem. Allah yahfazk ya Rabbi.
Okay, next question we have Farooq Hisham, I saw.
هاشم، فاروق هاشم.
هاشم هاشم يس.
يلا فاروق. How are you فاروق؟
السلام عليكم.
عليكم السلام. How is your daughter؟
الحمد لله. She is busy with the school still. جزاك الله خير. My question is that if the doctor prescribe an inhaler for if there is breathing difficulty to use it, otherwise not to, and then if the fasting person can use the inhaler for the difficulty of breathing.
Yes, you can use it and it does not break your fasting.
Exactly.
Yes, you can use it. The air will go, this kind of medication.
Yeah.
If you did it, if you that will go direct to the lungs, not the stomach, which is, does not affect the fasting. Your fasting is valid, inshallah.
Okay. Jazakallah khair.
Jazakum.
Jazakallah khair. We have had to fail with the bar. Also.
Yalla, go ahead.
تفضل. We can hear you. تفضلي. أنا أصبر شوي شيخ. I'm sorry.
لا لا no problem إن شاء الله.
طيب in the meantime عشان نشوف in the meantime في أخت تسأل why is Palestine decreed as the land of رحمة.
I did not say the land of رحمة but I mentioned the land of بركة.
الذي بارك.
The land of blessings. الله says إلى الأرض التي باركنا فيها للعالمين. So we have to be يعني careful when we translate the Quran. So Allah mentioned Palestine, the land of Baraka. Why? Because most of the prophets came to this area, Palestine.
جزاك الله خير. نرجع لأخت روز بطار. Are you ready? إن شاء الله. You can talk now. But we can hear something. Okay, they muted themselves, so I'll go back. Farooq Hashim also has another question, I guess. Let's go back, inshallah.
Okay, but the verse I was looking for, Allah says in Surah Al-An'am, not in Surah Al-A'raf, وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا طَائِرٍ يَطِيرُ بِجَنَاحَيْهِ إِلَّا أُمَمٌ أَمْثَالُكُمْ وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ. There is any single creation, دابة, any kind of animals. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ, verse number 38, وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Anything walking, even ants, insects, animals, whatever. ولا طائر يطير بجناحي. Any flies, any birds, any flies. ولا طائر يطير بجناحي. Mosquitoes or so. إلا أمم أمثال.